Hi guys, it's me, I'm back, and today I have a review for you of the XTank 4.0. And so let's open this bad boy up and see what we have. I did already open it and I did vape on it just because I noticed some problems with this, but don't worry because I did take care of it. So this is what you have. And it comes with the complete XTank 4.0 installed with a 0.6 ohm coil. Then your extra coil is a 0.2 ohm coil, and another extra coil is the Nikam 200 0.2 ohms. And then you get an extra replacement cover, and you get a user's manual. That's right here. Although it doesn't really help much when it's coming to this, because I don't know. So what I'm gonna do is I'm going to show you everything that comes in here, then we're gonna dive down, take a look at it, I'm gonna put it back together, and I'm going to just go over a few things with you. So it comes with the tank, it has a coil in here, comes with an extra, and this is plastic, and then it comes with two coils. You have no spare part baggie, because God forbid that they would pay attention to know that you need spare parts. And here is the user's manual. So we're gonna go down. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna take the drip tip off. You're gonna unscrew this piece, and just keep in mind, keep your stuff together. So if you guys are taking this apart, you know how to put it back together, because there are quite a bit of pieces here. Then you have that piece. Then this just pops off. Then you have a cap for your coil. Then you take your coil out here. We'll put that there. Then you turn this upside down. And I have to get a nickel, because I should really leave a nickel up here, but for some reason I keep putting it away. Okay, so what you want to do is you want to take a nickel, and use a nickel, but don't use a quarter that has ridges in it where you're going to scratch this up, because you don't want to get this all scratched up where it'll be hard to turn and stuff. So you just take this off and do-do-do-do. Now, this O-ring did not come with this tank, so I'm going to set that apart. I could just get this out. Okay, see this little O-ring? That did not come with this either. I'm sure you guys have some spare O-rings around the house somewhere, because throughout all this, this is an excellent tank. They just should have, I guess, maybe vaped on it or something before they just threw it together. Now, the problem is this part right here that you take off. This part is, it's a bottom fill tank. You can fill it through here, but that's too hard, so I'm just going to leave that out. But what happens is, this is also a leveler. so that when you put it on your mod, if it doesn't sit flush, you can undo this a little bit and it'll tighten it up on your mod. I'll show you when we come back up and I'll show you how it does all that. So what I found is when you open this up to make it flush on your tank, it leaks. So therefore, I just went ahead and took this little O-ring. I put it in there. You screw this back on. Oh, wait. Sorry. You take that O-ring and put it there. And you take this O-ring and you put it there. I don't know who put this, like, together that they didn't think it needed any O-rings. Because if they would have, like, taken the time and actually realized this, they would have seen that all they had to do was put them O-rings in. And this would have sat flush with every mod. But they didn't, so I'm just, you know, I do take what I do seriously, and I just want to bring all the correct information to everybody. That's why I did what I did before I brought this video to you guys. Then you're going to take your coil and you're going to screw it in here. Make sure you prime it first. It's like any other coil. Then you want to take your cap and you want to put it over your coil. Okay, and then you're going to pop your tank on. Make sure you got the holes in the right spot. The little hole goes where that long stainless steel piece is, and the big one goes where your coil is. So then you want to put this on here. You want to put this on here. And don't screw one down tighter than the other before you get them both on, because it'll just not, I don't know. I just like to do everything in equal parts. They even say that in the user's manual, to screw them on at the same time. Okay, so now that we have that back together, you take your drip tip and there you have the tank. Now we're going to come back up. Alright guys, now let me get my mod. So without the O-rings, this would normally, when I get it all screwed on here, this would normally move, like the whole tank would like swivel back and forth. But because I took my time and went over this with a fine tooth comb and figured out if you just put them those O-rings in there, you won't have a problem. So if you were to buy this, just get out your spare O-rings and get a little one, and then get a look at what's in the video and you'll see what you need. So now another thing is, they said that cinnamon vapes cannot go in this tank because they are plastic. So I figured, all right, let me get some more pieces. So I got three more plastic tanks. They were $2.99 a piece, so I figured, why not? I mean, I know you get an extra one in there, but, you know, me being so ballsy as I am, I said, if I'm going to do the review, I'm going to do it right. So all day, I have been vaping cinnamon vapes. have not had a problem. And this juice right here, Holy Cannoli, French Toast by Holy Cannoli, this has tons of cinnamon in it. Have not had a problem. So, I don't know how true that is, or if they're just saying that, so somebody's going to put cinnamon there and come back and say, well, you didn't say don't put cinnamon here, so it ruined my tank and I want a new one. I don't know if that has anything to do with it, but I just wanted to do vape on it all day with cinnamon just to see, you know, what it is, and I have not had a problem. So, like I said, down there where that piece was that you used the nickel, that's where they say fill it up. But that's not how I fill it because that is way too difficult. Now, my fingers are so greasy with Ejuice. When you, let me just bring you back down here for a second. See this little opening? You're gonna, it'll fit. You just take your liquid and you can fit that right there and fill it like any normal tank. I have the same Ejuice in this container because I did this earlier, but YouTube is having a problem and it totally deleted my video, so I'm doing it again. And I really do take my time with these tanks because I don't like to just go off what they say about the device. I actually like to vape it and see if what they're saying is actually true so that I help you guys out also when I'm doing this. So then you'll screw this back on. I'm not going to fill it all the way up just because I've been vaping this flavor all day and I want to switch. Actually, I'm going to but guys, I have to tell you, out of all the tanks that I've tried, this one has the most best flavor and good cloud production. It's craziness. So here we go. Let's vape. Let's open this. It has massive clouds, so my pros and cons, I don't have many cons. The only con is that they should have supplied O-rings and I know I had another con. What? Oh yeah, on this drip tip, they should have put silicone covers on them because it gets really hot if you vape too long. So the cons are just they should have put O-rings and silicone. Other than that, this is a beast and I love it. What I'm going to do is vape some more and I will make a second video to let you know if I have any more problems. But the leaking, I haven't had any more problems with after I put the O-rings in there. So I do suggest you put the O-rings in there. If not, you might get out of the house and have a mess on your hands. And guys, this holds a whopping 10 milliliters. So that's a big leak if it leaks. I don't think you want 10 milliliters of juice all over you. So once again, I did this review just so that I could, you know, take what they said and say, well, I didn't have this problem. I'm having no problems with the cinnamon. So I don't know what they're talking about, but I will keep vaping cinnamon in here. And if I ever have a problem, I will come back and let you guys know. But guys, that's all I have for you today. Please click like and subscribe, and I will see you in the next video. Bye.